Buenas tardes, bienvenidos a Café Latino. My name is Laura Fernandez, and I am actually creating this show all the way from New Delhi, India. So I'm very excited to be here, and we're going to play the very best of Latin jazz for you. Over the next 2 hours, I'm going to be your host, and I have a very special show for you today because I am doing it in conjunction with Colin De Cruz, who I have been in India with for the past month. And he is the founder of Jazz Goa and the leader of the ensemble Jazz Junction. I've been singing and performing and recording videos with them the whole month, and I'm very thrilled to have him as our guest today. We're going to be interviewing him in the second hour, and we are into our second hour now of Café Latino, and I'm very excited to introduce to you the wonderful bassist, Colin De Cruz. He's a composer, he's a bassist, and he is also the founder of Jazz Goa and Jazz Junction, and about to go to Goa tomorrow to be able to be a witness to the wonderful place where Jazz Goa was born, and where Colin De Cruz is based actually now. He used to live in Mumbai, I understand, and moved to Goa many years ago now, and he considers it his home. And we have Colin De Cruz here in the studio. Welcome, Colin.
Bienvenido a Café Latino. It's such an honor to have you here. And I should say, this is your studio that I'm a guest in today, because we're recording Café Latino here in Colin De Cruz's studio here in New Delhi, India. Tell us all about what's been going on here and how you came to be the founder of Jazz Goa. Why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself, Colin?
Hi, Laura. Thanks for having me on the show. It's such an honor being on a radio show that plays my kind of jazz. A big shout out to my fellow Goans in Canada. I hear it's a 50,000 strong community. Viva Goa! Viva Mogal Goenkara!
And hello from me too. Why don't we start off listening to one of your compositions?
Good idea, Laura. Here's Simple Samba and Sangolda Serenade on Jazz FM 91.
Great tunes, Colin. That was Sangolda Serenade preceded with Simple Samba. Do you want to tell us a little bit about these tunes and how you composed them, how you got into jazz in the first place?
Thanks, Laura. Simple Samba was the very first Latin jazz tune I composed. And the other one you heard, Sangolda Serenade, that one was inspired by my home in Goa at a place called Sangolda. I began playing professionally a long time ago, around 1978, and that was on hotel resident band contracts. Now, the bands that played at hotels in those days had a repertoire made mainly of jazz standards. So you can say I was thrown into the deep end of a swimming pool, you know, and that's where I had my first learning experience, learning jazz standards on the job.
Well, let me ask you this. What made you want to become a musician, and what made you pick the bass as your main instrument?
One of my fondest childhood memories is vividly remembering a live band performing at an event my parents took me to. For some reason, I could see there was some kind of magic happening on that stage. That stayed with me subconsciously, and I'm sure that was what started it all.
And what made you choose the bass?
I chose the bass for the same reason why your listeners would choose a good home stereo. Thumping sound of bass.
Okay. I love that. The thumping sound of bass and the magic of live music. One of the many conversations we've had over the past month was touching on the history of jazz in India. Why don't you tell us a little bit about that?
Right. Not many people may know that India had a simultaneous jazz scene going along with the rest of the world. And I can see why. Most Indian classical musicians are improvisers. Indian classical music is all about improvisation, which is something America discovered just 200 years ago, whereas Indians have been doing it for over 2,000 years now.
So you were jazzers all along.
Absolutely. Only thing, we had a different name for it.
And you were saying that Duke Ellington came to India?
Yes, most of the American jazz legends at some point or the other visited India. And that's because we used to host the longest running jazz festival in the world called the Jazz Yatra.
Did you ever attend the Jazz Yatra?
I not only attended, I made sure I was on stage alongside these legends.
Fantastic. Okay, we're going to go to break and we're going to be right back with more great music and more Colin DeCruz here on Jazz FM 91. This is Laura Fernandez. You're listening to Café Latino. And we are back. This is Laura Fernandez, and we are here in the studio with Colin DeCruz. And just a few minutes ago, we were talking about the Jazz Yatra, the longest running jazz festival in India. And you were saying a very specific artist was discovered at the Jazz Yatra. Tell us about it.
Yes, I'm sure many of you have heard of Tania Maria. She was discovered at one of the Jazz Yatras and now is a huge name in jazz.
Well, she's certainly a huge name on Café Latino because I play her all the time. So I'm going to just take this moment to play my favorite Tania Maria track. This is Sangria here on Jazz FM 91 from her album Viva Brasil. So that was actually a live version of Sangria that I found from Tania Maria's album Brazil, and that is how she would have been at the festival, I'm sure, at the Jazz Yatra. Tell us other artists that have influenced you and music that has inspired you, and maybe we'll play another one of your tracks as well.
I've been listening to a lot of Esperanza Spalding. He's currently my favorite bass player, composer, singer. How about some Esperanza Spalding?
Okay, we will do that. We played a little bit in the first hour, and we're going to play another Esperanza Spalding for you right now. Well, that was Esperanza Spalding with a track called I Know You, and that is from her album Esperanza. How have you been working with jazz, and how have you been incorporating it with your local music? Tell us a little bit about that.
Jazz has evolved into something really huge. It's not just about improvisation. It's about a meeting of minds and cultures. You'll find jazz in every corner of the world today. And why not in Goa, India? So you can say my contribution to the global jazz scene would be using jazz in our local music, Bollywood, and the local music in Goa.
Speaking of Goa and jazz, tell us a little bit about how you began and how you founded Jazz Goa and when it happened. What inspired you to do that? Because I know that you record artists from all over the world and put it out there for the world to hear. I know that you told me that you put it out for free because you want as many people as possible to be able to listen to it. It's an app that you can get on your phone, just like the Jazz FM app. And it is a great way for people to become aware of some of the music that you're working on.
Yes, Laura. The Jazz Goa app showcases jazz talent from India, and it's available as a free download at jazzgoa.com. I founded Jazz Goa after realizing that Goa is a global hub for jazz. Jazz musicians from all over the world visit Goa. In fact, the legendary saxophonist Henry Threadgill owns a home in Goa.
Yes, and in fact, he won the 2016 Pulitzer Prize for Music for his recording In for a Penny, In for a Pound. How long has Jazz Goa been around?
I set up Jazz Goa in 2004, so it's a good 15 years now. And in this time, a lot has been done. We've recorded over 300 artists. We've put up over 3,000 videos.
Wow.
Some of the tracks produced by Jazz Goa topped the international internet charts. And the icing on the cake is our Jazz Goa app.
Well, it's certainly very exciting, and I'm very honored to be a part of Jazz Goa now.
Okay, since you're honored to be a part of Jazz Goa, I think I'll make you an honorary Goan. In fact, your name is already Goan, Laura Fernandez.
Well, that is a very high honor.
Yes, Goa, a tiny state in India, yet the most beautiful place in the world. Goa has quite a few spoken languages, English, Portuguese, Konkani, and with Laura making an entry, there's Spanish too. So here's a song we've co-produced featuring Laura singing in all four languages, English, Spanish, Portuguese, and Konkani. Here's the song we've titled Sobit Goa, and it's dedicated to all the Goans in Canada. So here's Sobit Goa, making a global premiere on Jazz FM 91.
I love hearing those Latin rhythms. That's what Café Latino is all about. Tell us a little bit about that artist. I see he has the same name as I do.
Yes, and as they say in Goa, if you throw a stone, it will either land on a D'Souza or a Fernandez. So that was Sabi Fernandez, a Goan legend, a household name because most of his songs have been playing over the years in almost every Goan home. Like him, his counterpart and a legend is Lorna. Here's a song by Lorna now. That was Lorna, a Goan icon, a legend. She draws over 5,000 people at all her concerts in Canada and even more around the world. Now, if y'all have been enjoying music from Jazz Goa, make sure y'all download the app at jazzgoa.com.
Sounds good, Colin. And it's almost time for us to take another little break. And we will be back with more music and more Colin De Cruz. My name is Laura Fernandez. You're listening to Café Latino here on this Saturday afternoon. We'll be right back. This is Jazz FM 91. And we're back, and I've really been enjoying the interview here with Colin De Cruz of Jazz Goa and Jazz Junction. And I've really also enjoyed listening to these Goan legends. It's wonderful to hear this music because I wasn't aware of it, and I'm sure a ton of Jazz FM listeners are not aware. Can you tell us about another Goan legend that we can listen to?
I think every country has their jazz legends, and when it comes to India, inarguably, the jazz legend would be Braz Gonsalves, a Goan jazz legend and world-renowned saxophonist. Here's a song titled Our Love, composed by Braz Gonsalves' daughter Sharon Rodericks, and it features Braz himself on soprano saxophone. Our Love on Jazz FM 91.
Well, Colin, it's been an absolute pleasure to have you on the show. And I have to thank you so much for inviting me to India and for allowing me to get to know what you're all about and what Jazz Goa is all about and that people love Latin jazz all over the world. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you too, Laura. It's been a pleasure.
We're going to leave you with a very special piece called Samba de Goa from Joshua Costa. And I will be back next week with more great music. My name is Laura Fernandez. You have been listening to Café Latino here on Jazz FM 91.